I was often reprimanded for having too much fun in the orchestra and for trying to lead the orchestra from where I was, way in the back. And then, fortunately, my father took me to a young people's concert, and I saw this guy come out to conduct, and he was jumping around like a crazy person. And he was talking to the audience and, you know, laughing, and I thought, oh, well, if I'm the conductor, I won't get in trouble for having a good time because this guy's having a blast. And it was Leonard Bernstein. And so that was the day I saw Leonard Bernstein conduct live was the day I told my father I want to be a conductor. I was 9 years old. As the conductor, my first responsibility is to the composer. I'm the messenger for the composer. But my close next responsibility is to create an environment for the musicians to be the best they can be in the service of the composer. So I try to think of how to draw an analogy, you know, what would be a good parallel. And sometimes I think about being a director where, you know, you've read the playwright's words and you've developed a concept and a sense of what they mean. And then you have your actors, you know, like the musicians, that who are consummate professionals. And it's your responsibility to convince them that your interpretation of the author's words should become theirs, with their input as well. And then you all work toward this final goal of getting that message to the audience. I really believe that the most inspired performances are in large part a result of the audience and how focused they are. You know, I feel when the audience is with us. The preparation for a conductor, so much of it is done without one's instrument. So 95% of my preparation, I don't even have an orchestra. I only get to see the orchestra, you know, a couple days before the concert. So I've had to really think through, you know, the entire piece, why the composer wrote every note, why is it there, how can I get the story of the composer across, this piece across, you know, architecturally, dynamically, everything. And then I come into contact with my instrument only really in the home stretch, you know, running up to the finish line. I think that music plays a huge role in everyone's life. Music is often, it's often the language of individuality. It's the language of protest to our parents. It's the language of comfort. You know, when you have your first love and then you have your first breakup, you know, music is often, oh, that song. You know, we hear music and immediately we are transported to another moment in time. You know, it's a time machine for people. I think music also has that ability throughout our lives to transcend the words that are so often misunderstood. You know, music can connect us and bring us together, and you know, certainly that's what Bernstein believed. Certainly it's what I believe. Certainly it's what Beethoven believed. And I think it's truer today than it was even then. You know, I'm one of those people that if you tell me I can't do something, that's so motivating. You know, I just have to do it. Can't is my motivating word. And I think that's what you need to be a leader. You know, this desire to just come on, we can do it, and push us. And that's really the job of the conductor. I mean, it sounds trite in a way, but it is to try to inspire musicians to be the best they can be, which is what every artist wants to be.